Hello again, everyone.
Ready to roll.
Hope you're all well. Thank you for joining me. So we're off to Birmingham, I think. With some computer processors, wasn't it? Yeah. So a light load. But that's alright. And it's paying not much as well. Every little counts.
Keep right, and then turn right. Turn right. Keep left, and then turn left. Now, I remembered a little hack that I used to do in the DAF as well. So it was really, really hot. It was a really hot summer when I was working for them. And yeah, quite often on my break, I'd need the air conditioning on because it was just unbearable. Because obviously you've got a lot of glass in lorries, so it gets hot quick. It's like sitting in a greenhouse. And so one of the hacks that I found out about was, because obviously it's not good for the environment leaving the engine running, DAF engines switch themselves off after a few minutes of no activity. But if you tap cruise control, I think it was resume or something, it just raises the revs slightly. And it enables the engine to be left running. And I didn't used to do it all night or anything like that, but just for like 15 minutes or something to cool it down with all the curtains shut, then it was much more tolerable. And that has amazing air conditioning. nice. That Clio there, sorry, this is really unrealistic. That's the sort of Clio that I had that was K-wrench. That was really good in the snow. Yeah, I love that car. I didn't realise they were on it. And the Clio Williams is that shape. So it's that in a kind of darkish blue with gold alloys. Yeah, this game standard is a very good game, but add some mods in and it becomes fantastic. Pro mods, Jazzy Cat. Nice, mate, nice. Yeah, mine was a three door as well. It was in silver. Yeah, black bump, well, grey plastic bumpers, not colour coordinated. So it looked like a 50 quid car. But yeah, it was really good. Really low mileage as well. I haven't noticed Elsie doing any jobs recently. The lazy bitch. I might have just not noticed them though.
Keep left, then exit left. Exit.
bloody tractor. 5 in the morning.
Get ready to turn left.
Going the same way as us.
Turn left.
Currently uploading 3 more videos, if anyone's interested.
Go straight on.
Jesus.
Get ready to turn left.
Yeah, I have the ability to do lots of videos. So, that's something that some of the YouTubers are kind of lacking.
It was a nice ride.
They just do kind of 2 a week or something. Obviously we've all got different situations, but yeah, I can do a lot more than 2 a week. But I really need some input. Right, let's find out where we're going next. Back in a second. Right, we're going to do some roof lights down to Dover. And yeah.
Let's go.
And we're going abroad again. Anyone see it? Luckily, it's going the other way. Oh, mate. Yep. Bit of understeer.
Turn right.
Yeah, I think people would really like the option to have rigid lorries on here as well. It'd be good if I know that they've done a lot of development on this game, and I appreciate everything, as I've said before, but it would be good if you could start off with a van, then move up to a 7.5 tonner, then another rigid, maybe 18 or 26. Just kind of build it up from there. I think the money problem on here kind of ruins the game a little bit. So before I had this mod that lowered the so basically made it hard economy, I'll be playing it. Oh, just cut someone up, sorry mate. I'll be playing it and I'd start a new profile, and then within a few hours of playing I'd be a millionaire with the most upgraded truck that you could possibly get, biggest engine, all that kind of thing. And once you feel like you've completed a game, the replayability kind of fizzles out, doesn't it? But I think this mod's just about right. Obviously we have got a huge loan now, but that's alright. I think we're earning quite a bit more than the daily repayments. Oh, look at that, it's turned out nice. What is going on? What are you doing? I'm meant to be coming off here.
Get ready to turn left.
What, off here, John?
Turn left.
Yeah. Well, everyone was doing a bit of bad driving then. Me included. Nice bomb round the outside. The middle lane. Nope, don't need to. Nice. See you later, dagger win.
exit left. Keep left.
Bit of a frame rate drop then. What's happening? Carnes. Am I coming off here, John? Yeah, I don't know. Peugeot, maybe? An old Peugeot? I don't know. Oh! Concentrate on the road. Charlie Tango. My MGZT was called Victor because the number plate ended in VCT. And unfortunately, that car died about a year ago. It's still MOT'd until a year ago. That was 2004. So it did alright.
ready to turn left.
White Cliffs of Dover up there.
Turn left, and then turn right. Turn right.
And that'd be Dover Castle. Yeah, that's one of the most popular castles, I think.
This is where it ends.
There's Dover Castle, Leeds Castle, Hever Castle. We've got loads of castles. And the information about all of them can be found on the English Heritage site or whatever it's called. But yeah, I'm not really into castles. Starting to feel tired, so it gives me this one, doesn't it? Typical. I'm probably going to mess this up, I'll be honest. I'll try not to. I won't purposely do it. Crap. Right, how exciting, going abroad again. Right, I'm just going to pause it, back in a second. Okay, so it's the end of this episode now, but I think we're going to go radiators to Poland. Yeah, so we haven't been to Poland yet.
Let's do this.
Yes, let's, John. So what I'll probably do is go up to the ferry and then, yeah, have a break on the ferry. Cheers, mate. We're going to Poland.
Get ready to turn left. Turn left.
Another coach if anyone's interested. Over. I used to sometimes have to work in Dover, even though I live in Essex. And, yeah, that was a long journey home. Yeah, it used to really depress me. And I was the only one that drove, or that was allowed to drive. So I'd do a full day at work, hard work, and have to drive everyone home. But luckily, they didn't all sleep. So, that's the end of the episode. So, yeah, thank you for joining me. And have a lovely day. Hopefully see you again soon. Bye for now.